Hi YouTubers and fans of the Bat and the Cat. Today we are doing another adult life survival skill video, and we are doing a very important one, cell phone etiquette.
Definitely. Cell phones are great. They keep us in touch with each other and they are lifesavers in situations where you need help in emergencies, but they can also be very annoying.
Yeah, if it's not used thoughtfully, your phone doesn't have to control you. You have to control yourself to control your phone.
Yeah, your phone doesn't need to be on the whole time. You must use the apps and the settings that the phones have to regulate your time usage of your phone, like your silent rings and the messages and whatever else you can find on the apps.
No, but this thing turns people into zombies.
Definitely.
So we're going to give you some pointers as how to use your phone thoughtfully, and that is better for you and for the people around you.
Yeah, especially if you're going to visit friends or family and it's a gathering. You are there to visit the people, not your electronic device. You know, so put a message on your phone, say, I'm not available right now, I'll phone you whenever I get the time. And put your phone off. Spend the time with your family. You are never, ever going to get that time back. But you can always get it back to a message.
So first up is, be in control of your phone. Don't let the phone control you. Because people have the constant need of contact, and that is why you always, when the phone beeps, you check. I was there. I was constantly on my phone, 24/7. And it irritated a lot of people. It affected my business. People started complaining. My children started complaining. So I needed to change. So I decided there's no message that is so important that I must check it immediately. What you can do is, all the important people in your life, like the husband, the wife, the girlfriend, the boyfriend, your children, any other person that you need to know if they send a message immediately, I use a different ringtone or message tone, so that I know, listen, this is who's calling, I need to answer it, I need to look at the message. That's how you do it. All the other messages can go. Also, decide what you want on your phone. I deleted all the Facebook notifications, the email notifications. Because you only need to check your email 8 o'clock in the morning, during lunch, 1 o'clock, and just before you leave work. That's when you check your emails. If there's an urgent email, somebody will let you know they've sent you an urgent email. Mm. Or if you expect it, then you can check it. But you can do that on your laptop. So decide what is important to you and what you need to have on your phone. And that is how you control your cell phone.
Yeah, you must also remember that all of that stuff that's downloading is taking your data. If you don't have uncapped Wi-Fi 24/7, you're going to have a very large bill for data and airtime on your phone as well.
Yeah, the biggest commodity today is time. And if somebody or something steals your time, you won't get it back. And cell phone steals our time. Yeah. It steals time being in the real world, know what's happening around you. And that's why people get robbed or are in accidents or fall down cliffs or escalators or into fountains. We've all seen the videos on YouTube and in the social media. It's because you are concentrating on the wrong thing. You must concentrate on what's around you. And you must experience what's around you, not that what's on the phone.
It's like you always say, you need to be in the now. Yeah. Not inside the space when you are actually not seated on a chair in your house where you know you're safe.
Second one is speak softly, especially when you're around people. And another thing is when you are around people, as you're in a public place, you must look at your language. Yes. Also, no matter if the conversation is heated or not, but we all experienced or did this, like you talk at the top of your voice on the phone and laugh out loud, and nobody needs to know what is the conversation on the cell phone.
And in any case, they're only getting the one-way version. They don't know what you are laughing or shouting about. Okay.
Now, number three is be courteous to those you are with, and turn off your phone if it will be interrupting a conversation or activity or meeting.
Yeah,
that includes also going to the movies, and even if you have your social gathering and like a braai, turn off the phone or put it on silent. I mean, you're there to have a good time, not check your emails or your Facebook. What we usually do, we put our photos on Facebook immediately after we take it at a social function. That we don't have to do it later. But you need to take the other people into consideration. It's very, very rude to look at your messages or be on your phone the whole time when you you're even at lunch with somebody, or you're at a social gathering. Meetings are very, very important. I mean, you can't be on your phone. You're not concentrating on what's going on in the meeting. And it isn't creating a good image of your competence in a company when you're on your phone while a meeting is going on.
Yeah, or even when you're in a class, when you are taking a course in something, put your phone on silent or put it off completely until you get a break, and then you can check your phone. If it bothers others, use your silent mode. And if you have to speak, move away from the people to talk to the person, and avoid talking about your personal stuff, your confidential topics in a public place. It's got nothing to do with other people.
Yeah. Now number five.
You've done that.
Yeah, number six. Yeah, then it mustn't be on if it could bother others. If it must be on the cell phone, you use the silent mode. So you know when it vibrates, you know the message is coming through. That's just managing your phone so that you know there is a message, especially if you're expecting an urgent message.
Oh, and then also private info can be forwarded, so don't text it. Yeah, and never ever drive and use your phone at the same time. Not just are you going to get a heavy fine, you are putting yourself and others at risk.
Yeah, the things you have to manage, especially groups are a great problem on especially WhatsApp. People get irritated and leave groups because there's constant messages. But the most logical thing to do is you have a mute option for groups on your phone.
Yes.
Use it so that there's not constantly message tones coming through one after the other, because people can get busy on groups.
Mm.
So use that function. If you don't know how to do it, ask one of your kids. They probably do. So, and the other thing about cell phones is you mustn't replace cell phones with personal contact. And that's why people get addicted to their phones. They're craving that contact, and they're constantly on the phone, and you get people that get angry because they're waiting for a special message from the boyfriend or the girlfriend, and then you are messaging them. You are sending photos or jokes, and then they get very angry with you, and sometimes block you because of that reason.
Yeah.
Because they are expecting this urgent message, and every time they check their phone, it's not a message, it's you.
So, but then again, we get back to what you said. You put a special ringtone for that special person you want to interact with, and you wouldn't have that problem. And another thing that I've got a problem with is everybody playing games on cell phones all the time. Put that silent, put it on silent, please. Not everybody likes that monotonous tune that's playing in the background all the time.
Especially Candy Crushes.
Oh, yes, and that war thing. That's quite irritating. And when you are warfing, that one you play. And another thing, guys, if you are having family time, if you sit down to eat and you are all watching a movie, put your cell phones down. Because like what we've experienced before, everybody is on their cell phone while they are saying they're watching the movie. Really? That's not happening.
Yeah. Yeah, we're all culprits of that. But we all slip. But we need to manage ourselves. Because it's like guns and cars and alcohol and drugs and gambling. It's not the guns or the cars or the gambling or the drugs or the alcohol that's a problem or the cell phone. It's you. It's yes. It's you as a person. You are abusing the guns, the cars, the cell phones. You can't ban guns and think that's going to solve the problem if people are not learning the values and learning moral values.
Yes.
For that, and especially with the phones also. Another thing is we also slip up. You need to check your children's phones constantly, at least once in 3 months, to look at what they are Googling and what messages is happening on WhatsApp and the conversations. Some would think that it's an invasion of privacy, but I think you will be
horrified.
Not horrified, but you will be proactively stopping future problems that could escalate from these activities. And I mean, we all seen the newspaper headlines about children that sends porn and make porn videos, and they're still in high school. So you have to monitor your child's phone.
Yeah, and these child stalkers, or what do you call them, pedophiles. The internet media is awesome for them because they've got contact on Facebook, WhatsApp, you name it, groups into your child's life, and you are putting your child at risk by not taking that step and checking their phones, even though they don't like it. They can throw a tantrum, they are still your children and you need to keep them safe.
So, enjoy your cell phones. The most productive way, and don't let your cell phone invade your life, or don't let you allow your cell phone to invade your life and control it and make you unpopular with your family and friends. So please subscribe to our channel, watch our videos, like our videos, and click on the notification bell.
And I'm still waiting for the comments. I haven't seen one. So please, guys, challenge us. What do you want us to do?
This is the Bat signing out.
And the Cat signing out.